Hello YouTube, Senior Music here. After making those other Outlaws videos lately, I'm back with a follow-up on the railroad building nightmare, the true extent of the map, and a couple other things. After recording another 4 hours of in-game footage, and I'm getting closer to that magical 20 hours I said I wouldn't do in the first follow-up video, I have more to show you all. So after giving up initially on the Senior Railway Conglomerate idea, I decided to come back and try to sort the trackway out. Boy, was I in for some frustration and several wasted hours. I managed to build what turned out to be over an IRL mile of track, going over the ridgeline and through the valley to the north and then turning west to another pasture. Sadly, I didn't record the initial new track extension, only thinking to start recording once I came to the point of trying to connect the new and original track segments. Let me just say, fuck this game's railway building mechanics. Holy smokes, this crap is mind-numbing. Railway building is easily screwed up, i.e. double and triple track placements if you just walk forward and spam left click with the railway hammer, and finicky as hell. There's so many terrain no-no squares where railway track just won't place or snap to adjacent tracks that it makes the whole process feel like trying to catch smoke with a butterfly net. So I wound up with two main track segments that were each connected to their respective lengths, but would not, and I repeat, not, connect to each other, no matter what I tried. I first built the whole track out across over a mile of terrain, then reached a point where I couldn't place any more track near the edge of a sharp drop-off. Then I started testing the track and found out that nothing was connected to anything else. Holy crap, that took forever to sort out to get the new segments completely connected. You can only test the track by looking at a single segment, holding right click, and then selecting the Test Track System feature, which highlights the connected segments in a Halloween orange color that does stand out across distance pretty well. The real trick here is being able to see all of the track you're trying to test in one go. So after getting these two rather long lengths built, I isolated the break in the track to a single square. Now, try as I might, this was a complete no-go. The track wouldn't connect together. I couldn't take it around to either left or right from either side to make it connect, and I couldn't get the two halves to sync up. After many dozens of minutes of faffing about, I finally just deleted the whole new track segment. This was a painful click. After I deleted the tracks, the locomotive returned to the station on an invisible track that was freshly demolished. What? So then I tried altering the original track segment to see if I could find more favorable ground. This was also an exercise in futility, as I kept running into no-no squares no matter which route out of the valley to my town I took. I did figure out that when you get one of these no-no squares, back up three track segments, i.e. delete three pieces of track, and then try to go around in either direction. But sadly, when you can't go in any direction from a certain point, you just have to give up. I wound up with this crazy three-way rail split with segments going left, straight, and right, but wasn't able to complete any of the new track lengths. I tried one more workaround by taking the main line right out of the valley to the town, and oddly, the tracks would snap up a 270-degree spiraling left turn up a small hillside, but after cresting it, I ran into yet more no-no squares and had to give up. And oddly, during this experiment in patience, the locomotive suddenly spawned on my cowboy, much to my surprise, then proceeded to suck its own railway dick, as you can see here. As amusing as this was for about 2 minutes, it was yet another reminder this game is broke. So after about 10,000 iron bars and planks, and finally embracing the inevitable, I just deleted the whole track and started over. Another very painful click. Trying a new main line out of the station, I deleted everything but the starting rail, then started building out the opposite way of the station. I played with directions some and found even more no-no squares in the valley, eventually getting stuck with this funky snaking route around the valley to the town's entrance. Again, my choice of town locations seems to have heavily affected my ability to even have a railroad. But hey, look! A choo-choo! So the next topic up for discussion is the map and the coordinate system yet again, but not in as much detail this time. So after writing down to the southern and southeastern legit edges of the map, I was going to try flying the whole north-south line of the map in first person while recording to get some terrain simulator footage, but I wound up warping a tad too far on one teleport and being stuck outside of the map boundaries. Unable to teleport back inside the map or run back inside the map, I decided to just see how far this thing goes. I called my horse Glue 3 and headed due south with a total disregard for consequences. At first, all was going well. I still had a map marker, and I was getting to see some admin level stuff like unfinished terrain, weird lighting effects, partial occlusions, and vanishing mountain ranges. The map went further than I expected. Then the footfall sound stopped. I guess this was due to the game no longer registering terrain underneath me. On and on into the fading light I rode, nary a care in the world, thinking of only how far does this go. Then something weird happened. I found the edge of the world and started falling. Ironically, my horse was still leveling up in freefall, and I was still covering ground according to the coordinates readout. But my map marker was gone, and it got so dark that even maxing out gamma barely showed anything around me. The interesting part here was that the map itself changes when you max the gamma out. The patch I was running around on outside the boundaries was shown as dark black. But then there's this weird patchwork of squares showing this game truly isn't nearly finished. Early access my foot, more like proto-access. I fell for a long time, and I mean a long time. The coordinates never stopped moving, and I can say for sure that the map is at least 40 kilometers north to south, not 20 or even 18. After the Y coordinate reached 4 million, I just gave up and committed suicide in-game to respawn, as apparently this wasn't ever going to stop. Good old Blue 3 then died also. Rip Blue 3 was a good horse. So, after a quick excursion to withdraw money from the bank, my first trip was to the gun store for more guns and ammo, cause cowboys. Then to the clothing store to get a new outfit sorted out. Now, back in proper cowboy mode, onto something else. Two more things I haven't mentioned yet. Mines and target practice. Mines are, in vanilla gameplay, where you make your real money. Both Tier 1 and Tier 2 mines can be purchased from NPC vendors for money and give you basically a dungeon crawl in search of treasure. I'm going to show you inside of a Tier 2 mine, as the Tier 1 mines are pretty small. Mines require oil to run, and are only active a short time even from a full stack of oil. There's iron, gold, silver, and sulfur nodes down here, as well as crazed miners of several varieties. You get these gimp suit looking mofos who swing their giant axes at your squishy bits. Then there's these crazy Uncle Ernie types who throw dynamite like monkeys throw poo. Then these old timers with either picks or bird cages on sticks that will smash your head in. After fighting off small hordes of these guys, you're free to claim as much gold and silver as you can pick up until your pick breaks or the mine runs out of oil. You can then melt the ore down into ingots and sell for money. Also, there's targets you can set up for some range practice. You can do this with the HUD on or off in first or third person. I like the third person HUD off option myself. The targets will report damage done when hit. This can be a fun bit of fluff for you and your friends on the server, as well as some quick draw bragging rights if you can constantly hit the first time without the HUD on. Another minor complaint I have is, why in the world did the dev team use a modern Smith & Wesson 44 Magnum revolver icon for the early access version number? Come on guys, it's a cowboy game. Give us the outline of a Colt Peacemaker or a Civil War era single action revolver, not a Smith & Wesson Model 29 revolver that was made starting in 1955. I know it's a small gripe, but it's a legit gripe, dammit. I did also run into a wandering NPC vendor this time, which is something I hadn't seen before now, so that's pretty cool. He was peddling some meat, cooking implements, and coffee. Nice to have some wandering general vendors out in the world. Now if only there was a wandering gun merchant, that would be cool. So what did we learn from all this? Well, the railway system is broke as a joke and the map isn't finished yet. Hooray for early access and the limited liabilities that come with it when you buy game titles such as these. From now on, I'm just going to stay on the legit part of the map and have my adventures. I'll use teleport for one grid at a time, as this seems to be the only reliable way to make it work, and I'll keep cowboying it up until I get tired and move on to something else. I do plan to try to find an area flat enough to make a working railway, but I possibly can't be bothered after all this. Time will tell. Thank you all very much for watching, and have a great day. Senior Musica, out.